We want to combine the log expressions into a single log by using the log properties given here below in red. And since we're combining logarithms, we'll be using these properties in this direction. Looking at these first two properties, notice that in order to combine a sum or difference of two logarithms into a single log, the coefficients of the logarithms must be 1. So in these examples, the first step will be to apply the power property of logarithms, which states we can move the coefficient of the logarithm into the position of the exponent on the number part of the log. So for 5 natural log x plus 1/2 natural log y minus 7 natural log z, our first step will be to move this 5 to the exponent on the x, the 1/2 to the exponent on the y, and the 7 to the exponent on the z. So we'll have natural log x to the 5th plus natural log y to the 1/2 minus natural log z to the 7th. Now the next step, we'll combine these two logs. Again, they're both natural logs. We have a sum, so we can apply this product property of logarithms. Because we have a sum, we can combine them into a single log by multiplying the number part of the logarithms. So this is equal to the natural log of x to the 5th times y to the 1/2, and we still have minus natural log z to the 7th. And now we can combine these two logarithms. Again, they're both natural logs. The coefficients are 1, and we have a difference. So we can combine them into a single log by forming this fraction here. Notice how the number part of the log that we're subtracting ends up in the denominator of the fraction. So this is equal to the natural log of x to the 5th, y to the 1/2, divided by z to the 7th. And if we wanted to, we could rewrite y to the 1/2 as the square root of y. We'd have the natural log of x to the 5th square root y all over z to the 7th. And now we have the given log expression as a single logarithm. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, the first step will be to apply the power property of logarithms. So we'll move this 4 to the exponent on the 2, we'll move this 2 to the exponent on the 3, and we'll leave log 4 as is. So we can write this as the common log of 2 to the 4th minus the common log of 3 to the 2nd minus log 4. Now here we can evaluate 2 to the 4th, that would be 16, and 3 to the 2nd would be 9, so we need to go ahead and do that. This is equal to the log of 16 minus the log of 9 minus the log of 4. Now let's go ahead and take this 2 at a time. Here we have a difference of two logarithms with the same base and a coefficient of 1, so we can combine these into a single log by forming a fraction with the number parts of the logarithms. So this is equal to the common log of 16 divided by 9 minus common log of 4. And now we can also combine these two logarithms. And again, since we're subtracting log 4, the 4 will end up in the denominator, or in this case, will be multiplied by the 9 that's already in the denominator. So this is equal to the log of 16 divided by 9 times 4, which would be the log of 16 over 36, which does simplify. 16 and 36 do share a common factor of 4. There are 4 fours in 16, and there are 9 fours in 36. So this simplifies to the common log of 4/9. Okay, I hope this helps explain how to combine log expressions into single logs.